Let us look at increment and decrement operators. I have a variable I, and this is 5. Now, one method of incrementing value of I is I assign I plus 1, or else I can say I plus assign 1, or even I can say I plus plus. This is a unary operator. We don't need any other thing. Like here we require 1, but here nothing is required. So this will increment the value of I. Let us try to print the value of I and C and L. I became 6. Even if I write plus plus I, then also I get the same result. 6. Then what is the difference between pre-increment and post-increment? Like this is called as pre-increment, and writing I plus plus is called as post-increment. Let us see the difference. Here I will take one more variable, that is j, and I will say j assign with I plus plus. So I am using post-increment. Let us print the value of I as well as j. Let us see these values. I am incrementing I and also assigning the result in j. So let us see what happens, whether the assignment is done first or increment is done. See, I became 6 because I has incremented and j is 5. So it means the first value of I is assigned in j, then the value of I is incremented to 6. If I write it other way, like plus plus I, let us see what happens now. Both are 6, so it means the value of I is changed to 6 plus first, that is I plus plus, then the result is assigned to j. So this is pre-increment and that one was post-increment. I'll add one more expression here. I will say 2 multiplied by plus plus I and 2 multiplied by I plus plus. So if I guess the value, it should be value of I is 5, so it should become 6. Then 6 should be multiplied by 2, so this should become 12. Then this I value will increment afterwards, so still I is 6, so this is 12, so the result should be 24. Like already I have discussed that we should not use a multiple increment decrement operators on the same variable inside single expression. So multiple unsequenced modifications to I. This is a warning showing you that we cannot guarantee you the results whatever you are expecting. So let us run and see. We are expecting 24 from here. Okay, we got 24, that's good. So we got the correct result. Now if I write this as I plus plus, so I guess that value of I will change afterwards. So this should be 2 into 5, that is 10. Then I change to 6, so 6 into 2, that is 12. So this should be 22. Yes, I'm getting the same result. But here, whatever I was expecting, I was getting the same result. It may not be true in every compiler of C++. You can try in different compilers and check the results. The results may vary. Now, similarly, as we have increment operator, decrement operators are also there. They are also pre-increment and post-increment operators are there. So you can try those operators.